Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from Group 7. Let me introduce our group first. The first is Muhammad Sandi Fahreza, and the second is Muhammad Syafri Al-Iza Adzana, and the third is Muhammad Zaki. Today, we will present about high-rise building, and we will present about Tamrinan Tower. Tamrinan Tower is a mixed-use super block that located in MH Tamrin Street, Jakarta. This building contains office, retail, residential, hotel, sport, and entertainment facilities. And the fact about the Tamrinan Tower, the first is the tallest building in Indonesia, and next is the tallest building in south of Ecuador, and the third is green and energy efficient building. Tamrinan Tower construction schedule. Tamrinan Tower has two buildings. The first is called Autogroup Tower, and the second building is called Luminary Tower. And the schedule of the first Autogroup Tower is proposed from 2013 and completed in 2021. And the second building is Luminary Tower is proposed from 2014 until the construction complete in 2021. The building location of Tamrinan Tower is located at MH Tamrin Street, Jakarta, Indonesia. It is located at the strategic area because it is close to the public facilities. Public facilities close to NAM Tower is the first is Transjakarta Bus Stop, Duku Atas MRT Station, Bundaran HI, and the Grand Indonesia Shopping Center. The dimension of Tamrinan Tower. The first is Autogroup Tower. Autogroup Tower has architectural height of 333.5 meter or 1,094 feet. And the second tower is Luminary Tower, has an architectural height of 275 meter and or 902 feet. Project involved parties. The first is Autogroup Tower is owned by Putra Gaya Wahana and architect by designed by Kohn Pedersen Fox Associates and the architect of record by Paramita Abirama Ista Sadayana. And the second is Luminary Tower. The owner is by Putra Gaya Wahana and architect designed by Kohn Pedersen Fox Associates and the architect of record by Paramita Abirama Ista Sadayana. The concept design project Tamrinan Tower is inspired by the nearby UOB Plaza Tower. Tamrinan Tower one meant to rise with a visual presence that stem from its high proportion and simple extruded surface. And this is the picture Tamrinan Tower during construction. And the next is Tamrinan Tower during construction. The reason for choosing this building. The reason we choose this building because Tamrinan Tower is known as the tallest building in Indonesia. Autogroup Tower has a many advantages, such as an observation tower where the visitor can see the beautiful skyline of the city of Jakarta. Besides that, this building has a sky garden and skywalk so that visitor can walk, eat, gather, and spend time at a height of more than 350 meters. Tamrinan Tower has certified as green and energy efficient building. This building also has many green open areas, large vertical garden, and architectural design made in such a way as to maintain internal temperature and energy. And this is the detailed engineering design of Tamrinan Tower. And the left side is the first Tamrinan Tower or Autogroup Tower. And the right side is the second Tamrinan Tower or also called Luminary Tower. A detail about structure system or Tamrinan Tower. The structure system is using buttress, core wall, composite column, secondary beam, primary beam, or trigger. Steel wall and column reinforcement design that used in Tamrinan Tower. And the next will present by my partner is Muhammad Sandi Fahreza.
Okay, thank you to Zaki. Next, we move to structural system of Tamrinan Tower. The structural system used in the Tamrinan Tower 1 building is a combination of couple shear wall system with outrigger and belt truss system that is mounted on 35 until 36 floors and 55 until 57 floors. Outrigger and belt truss system that using steel material is combined on composite column element. The system is mounted on the MEP floor, so it is not interfere the functional of the building. The type of technology used in the building structure system. The technology used in this building is environmentally friendly technology, which feature green open area, vertical garden, water and waste treatment, bicycle parking, and architectural design and features are made in such a way as to maintain internal temperature in order to save energy. Next. The strength and weakness of the structure. The first is outrigger and belt truss system. The strength is significant reduction and possible loss of upward and tensile force through column and foundation. And the outer framing can be simple plain beam and column framing without the need for rigid frame joint, making building planner more economical. But the weakness is leave sufficient space on the floor where the outrigger and belt truss are installed, and how to connect the shear wall with the outrigger and belt truss is very complicated. The second is shear wall. The strength of shear wall is can dampen shock during the earthquake, increase the strength of the building, minimize building maintenance costs, and increase wall carrying load. The reason for the selection structural system of Tamrinan Tower. By using this combination system, the building will be more economical, efficient, and easier to work on. In the Tamrinan Tower, in the Tamrinan Project Tower 1, is used a design using an average CS value that is smaller than CS minimum but above actual CS. It is very clear that the more flexible the building, the higher the SA value determined by the minimum CS. By using the average CS value, the force value is obtained shear below the value of the shear force with a minimum CS, so that is that it is possible optimization of supportal building structure design. With the average CS design, still meet the performance target and risk, so it is worth it construction. Other related information of structural system. By using the mean CS value for performance-based design analysis, force the earthquake use becomes smaller and has an impact on reduced demand reinforcement, especially on vertical element. That is the comparison. Next. Based on these two pictures, proven that by using the design performance-based design and supported by good nonlinear analysis results are obtained much smaller reinforcement requirement. It will have an impact on its simplicity construction in the field and will eliminate the risk of damage to the concrete as a result aggregate that cannot enter into the concrete core. Next, we move to substructure of Tamrinan Tower. Substructure of substructure is the part of the building that is underneath the ground. Substructure of Tamrinan Tower are foundation work and retaining wall. The first is foundation work, that is bore pile foundation. Tamrinan Tower used two type of bore pile foundation. There are the type one is bore pile with diameter of foundation is 1,200 millimeters and has a depth of 90 feet. And the second type is bore pile foundation with diameter of 1,000 millimeter and has a depth of 58 feet. The second is retaining wall, that is diaphragm wall. Diaphragm wall is a type of retaining wall that has dual function, as a retaining ground and also function as a wall on the basement. The diameter of the diaphragm wall Tamrin 9 tower is 800 mm and has a depth of 36 feet. This is the example of board pile foundation and diaphragm wall. And then the first picture is the installation of the board pile foundation, and the second picture is installation of diaphragm wall. This is the picture of construction of board pile foundation and retaining wall. Next, we move to construction implementation method for the substructure. The first is foundation construction. The method used in the installation of the foundation pile using post-grounding method that can be reduced to 90 meters and will speed up the implementation period as much as about 3 months and reduce the risk of sliding holes. Next. And the second is basement construction. The basement construction of Tamrin 9 Tower used the up-down method because the development area is limited in urban area. There is a ground anchor method in the work of diaphragm wall as an additional structure to help counter the lateral ground pressure during basement construction. Technology and substructure material. The material is ready mix concrete, reinforcing steel, betonite slurry, betonite cement, panel and electrical equipment, strand and anchor head. The technology is hydraulic drilling rig, service crane, temporary single wall casing, auger, bucket, cleaning bucket, rock drilling bucket, hydraulic jack, grout pump, hydraulic pump, and theodolite. Substructure analysis. With the combination of structural system and substructure system, note that Tamrin 9 Tower able to withstand the risk of earthquake and still safe for 50 years later. The advantage of substructure, the first is bore pile foundation. The advantage is large excavation and subsequent backfill are minimized, less disruption, vibration is relatively low, and in for main design situation, bore pile offer high capacities with potentially better economics. Next. And then the advantage of diaphragm wall is can reduce number of join in the wall, which ultimately improve the wall water tightness. And diaphragm wall construction is relatively quiet and minimum noise and vibration level make it suitable for construction in urban area. Next, we'll present by Safriel.
Thank you, Sandy. Architecture of Tamrin 9 Tower. Number one, column. In the column, Tamrin 9 Tower is concrete encased steel. Concrete encased steel is structural steel encased in reinforced concrete. By combining these two materials, the column can handle large amount but with a smaller percentage area. In additional, the increase of the overall rigidity of the building and provide significant assistance to lateral load. This column is widely used in multi-story building construction. Next, core or cell. The core or structure of the Tamrin 9 Tower wood is used reinforced concrete. This concrete is concrete and is given steel as reinforcement. So that's the layer or skin has steel reinforcement. Instead of the reinforcement, aims to increase the strength of the concrete in case tensile form. As in general, concrete is unable to withstand compressive force, but cracks easily when touched with tensile force. In contrast to steel, the material can sustain the tensile and compressive force cylindrical nose. Next, floor span or floor plate. The floor plate, aluminum tower 1 and 2 are different. Aluminum tower 1 use the same types of concrete as the core, namely reinforced concrete, while aluminum tower 2 use steel. Next. Number 4, beam. Aluminum tower beam use a concrete encased steel beam. Type of concrete is a steel beam that encased concrete on both sides. This PE beam has several advantages, include better fire resistance, higher bending strength, and better resistance to lateral torsional buckling compression to ordinary steel beam structure. Next, detail engineering design of the aluminum tower. Question number 1 is steel wall of aluminum tower, and question number 2, column is picture column AT of aluminum tower, and picture number 3 is the AT beam of aluminum tower. Next, construction implementation method for the upper structure. Column box, seconds of column box, preparation, column reinforced with steel, manufacture of column from box, casting of column from dismantling. Next, to shear wall work, floor process, excavation, foundation, and parts from box making and casting. Excavation, this process is carried out using heavy equipment, which is excavator. After excavation process, the foundation of shear wall is ready to be placed. Bonding use will be put to the top during the reinforce process. After the reinforce process, the next process is formwork making. The formwork used will be installed up into its position. The last step is scoring process that using the next concrete. Next, brief beam and floor plate work. Beam and floor plate turn at almost the same time. The process are preparation, from box making, and box making, casting, from dismantling. On beam and floor plate, from box is created in the beginning. At the same time, reinforce also create at the location. The from box is ready, and box will put down and on their position. And the last step in casting process is creating mix concrete with the help concrete preparator. Next, on this picture, picture number 1 is reinforced construction, picture number 2 and 3 from work making, picture number 3 casting. Next, technology and material use on upper aluminum tower. Material used on upper structure aluminum tower, like mixed concrete, concrete quality, cement, and for steel, column pin, beam, floor plan, EWF profile steel, paper T-wire, and taking concrete. Technology used upper structure aluminum tower. Tower plan, scaffold pin, concrete pump, concrete T-wire, theodolite, water pass, mixer screw, paper web, foam rock, or cutter, and or bender. Next, upper structure analysis. Nonlinear modeling of beam and the column uses impending moment pattern to relationship as structural element obtaining by integrate the curvature along a beam, which are undertaken at 0.5 cross-section. Cladding wall element is paper element analysis, where the analysis is based on the strain relation of the constituent material of the element. complete beam element are modeled by fiber element modified by x addition of x diagonal per element to represent diagonal reinforced in existing condition. Next, in the Tamlinian tower structure one, system the expected classification of the ismut only occur at main beam element, column, coupling, open beam, and servall. The determinant of the performance level Tamlinian tower one structure is taken first on the locally acting criteria for certain element that is to ST14-1-13. Determinant in the performance limit the element itself can be divided into two kinds, namely control and force control deformation. Next. Thank you.
Is our presentation. Sorry for any mistake. Thank you for attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.